Hey guys, it's me. You already know my name, so I won't bother introducing myself. But today, I will teach you about a famous American playwright named August Wilson. Frederick August Kittle Jr. Born April 27, 1945 in the Hill District of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, to an African-American mother named Daisy Wilson and a white German immigrant named Frederick August Kittle Sr. Mom, how are you, my child? You look grown. He was the fourth to be born of six children in a household where his father was mainly absent from his childhood. Hey, I'm a white guy of German descent, and what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 kids! Oh, you know what, honey? I think it's time that I leave you. Goodbye. At the age of 5, he moved to Hazelwood, an economically disadvantaged, predominantly African-American, Italian-American, and other working-class white immigrant neighborhood. They encountered a very, very racist breed of people that often hurled bricks at their new home.
Go away. We don't like your kind around here. I'm gonna belt this rock at your face and throw it at your house. Yeah!
Which forced them to move out to another house. By 1959, August was the only African-American student attending Central Catholic High School.
Oh great, I'm the only black guy in my class again. Isn't life just peachy?
He faced racial hostility and soon left the school only to go to another school he deemed as unchallenging by the name of Connelly Vocational High School. In 1960, he was at Gladstone High School, where he was accused of allegedly plagiarizing an essay on Napoleon I of France.
Even though I watched you write that essay all by yourself, and I know that you're smart, but I'm gonna deny it anyway because I'm a white lady and I know what you're talking about, and you're black, so you probably copied it from an encyclopedia, so I'm gonna fail you and stuff.
He dropped out and started doing menial work, which enabled him to meet many different people, which later influenced the development of future characters such as Sam in his 1985 theatrical piece, The Janitor.
Okay, we'll see who has the last laugh. And to be honest, I don't want to be here anyway. I know I'm going to be a famous playwright in like the next couple decades anyway, so really this doesn't even matter.
Throughout his childhood, starting at the age of 4 all the way into his teenage years, August was an avid reader at the Carnegie Library of Pittsburgh. Hey, I'm Frederick. I like reading books that haven't even come out yet. It's 1960-something. He would educate himself by reading the works written by many prevalent African-American writers, such as Langston Hughes, Ralph Ellison, Richard Wright, and many others. He then obtained a high school diploma from the Carnegie Library.
Hey, I got my diploma.
He bought a typewriter for $10 and took it everywhere he went. You know, maybe before I become a playwright, maybe I should become a poet. You know, a typical 20-year-old hipster face. Let me break out the laptop. Local bars. Cafes, cigarette stores. That's where he would sit for hours listening to the variety of accents and dialects of people around him.
Man, why your eyes got me running back and forth, man? All I wanted was some roti. Quiero taco, quiero burrito. Me gusta tacos, me gusta nachos, me gusta. Bon appétit, mademoiselle. Oui, oui. Oh, pamplemousse, pamplemousse.
All good material for new characters for his writings. August then decided he wanted to become a playwright.
Oh my god, this is gold.
you know what I feel like doing? I'm out of that, like, emo, like, poet phase. I now feel like becoming a playwright. He drew heavy inspiration from the teachings of Malcolm X and the, oh my gosh! And the Black Power movement, which is self-determination, self-sufficiency, and self-defense. This is my Malcolm X face. I'm determined, I'm self-sufficient, and I know self-defense! Ground on Which I Stand, made in 1996, is an example of a play made with this philosophy. But in 1968 is when he made his first official play called Recycling. Guys, I'm having a play, it's called Recycling, so if you want to come down, it's only 50 cents. This is what I have now, and it's really not even enough to buy a Happy Meal at McDonald's. Performed for audiences in small theaters, schools, and public housing community centers for only 50 cents. People often inquired him on who would be the director of his works.
August, who thou shall be the director of your plays?
And he simply replied, I will.
Whoa! Watch out, we have a bad boy here.
Since he was a frequent visitor at the library, he knew his way around it. He went to look for a book on how to direct a play, and found one called The Fundamentals of Play Directing, and that's how he learned to master the craft of play directing. In 1976, he was getting the hang of producing theatrical masterpieces, and it was time he started expanding his contacts with other people involved in the theater field. Vernell Lilly, who founded the Kuntu Repertory Theater at the University of Pittsburgh 2 years before, helped direct August's The Homecoming play. Just a couple years later, in 1978, his friend Claude Purdy helped him get a job in St. Paul, Minnesota.
Hey, my name is Claude. Claude Purdy. I can help you get a job in showbiz.
Will it involve me working in St. Paul, Minnesota, working in a science museum? Writing educational scripts for the Science Museum of Minnesota. In 1980, he received a fellowship for the Playwrights Center in Minneapolis. Just a year after, he quit working at the museum, but continued to write his own plays. In 1984, he got married to his first wife, Judy Oliver. Things did not work out, so he got divorced in 1990. Then he moved to Seattle, Washington. There, he would develop a relationship with the Seattle Repertory Theater, which would become the only theater in the country to produce all of his works in the 10-play cycle of his one-man show called How I Learned What I Learned. Even though he was a writer dedicated to theater, a Hollywood studio wanted to help develop his signature play, Fences, into a grand movie. They wanted to use a white director, but Wilson declined because he said the white guy directing a film that deals with African-American culture wouldn't be able to relate.
But I heard you half white yourself. Heard you about full wrong, now get out!
Was never produced. In 1985, theatrical masterpiece Fences takes place in his hometown of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. The theme is drama nonfiction. Characters, a 53-year-old man named Troy Maxson.
I'm a 53-year-old baseball player.
He was a great baseball player who played in the Negro League, but was not able to join Major League Baseball due to the closed-minded people not wanting black people to play.
See, look, heroes of baseball. I'm one of them. Hey, hey, hey!
He also accidentally murdered someone, so he was sent to jail for some time. And by the time he came out, he had no money and no skills, so he became a garbage man. Thank you.